Hello, my name is Vicky Lindbo Swick, and I'm a very proud and honored daughter of Dorothy and Harry Lindbo, and we are all blessed, all her family, to be a part of Dorothy's life. What a beautiful tribute to our mother today. Thank you so much for being here with our family to support us and celebrate Dorothy Lindbo's life. Our mother loved, my mother's love was truly a gift from God. She had a sweet and tender spirit that touched so many lives. Many years ago, my mother and I would always go to PLU just before Christmas, and there would be a harp playing. And that's the reason why my harp is here today, is because when I was with her, she said, "Oh my goodness," she says, "that reminds me of Grandma Meyer." She said, "When I was little, I would always be over at her house, and she would say, 'You know, Dorothy,' she says, 'you need to play the harp someday.' She says, 'because you are my angel.'" Our mother was a very wise lady. She taught me how to trust God and to love others. She always said, "Follow your dreams, Vicky. Work hard and pray hard. You do the work and God will lead you." There are, throughout my growing up, the stages in my life, she was there for me, encouraging me, believing in me, and helping me to reach beyond myself. Whenever I was in the hospital, she would be there. Whenever Cody and Casey were born, when they were born, she would be there. She was just always there with all, each and every one of us, whenever we needed her. She loved her children, especially during the sweet angel. And she truly loved her grandchildren very much. She always had the cute stories to tell them about themselves when they were growing up. She was strong and courageous and relied on God's strength. She lived by prayer and example. Our mother was an amazing prayer warrior. I know she was my personal prayer warrior. Whenever I asked her to pray for me, the answer would always follow shortly after that. Our mother started working for Bethel School District to keep a watchful eye on her children. After all, she had 7 children in under 8 years. The district office was next to Bethel High School, and I had the privilege of going there and typing invoices during the day. Well, one time I skipped school, and when I came back to school, she was standing outside the district office giving me the look. I never skipped school again. My mother was so proud when I became a teacher. Throughout the years when people found out that Dorothy was my mother, they replied by saying, "I just love your mother. She is a trusted and respected co-worker." One person said, "I thought she was a superintendent by the way she presented herself. Your mother is amazing. When I need an answer to a question, I go to Dorothy. You have the most wonderful mother. I'm proud to call her my friend." And you can't mention Mom without including Dad. They had an amazing love for each other and a sweet teaching story to the end. Mother's final hours, I thought you should know, it's always nice to hear about how she was on her last day. Our mother had a heart attack at her home. When we rushed her to the hospital, there was the most brilliant was filled with family on our side, and we had a moment to express our love and to pray for her as well. There was a point when it was time to encourage her to be with the Lord she loves so much in heaven. Telling her to let go and let God. Mom, just let go and let God. And I began to sing a song, and it's Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. There's just something about that name. Master, Savior, Jesus, like the fragrant after the rain. Let all heaven and earth proclaim, kings and queens shall all pass away, but there's something about that name. And let it earth remains and went to heaven. And God said, well done, thy good and faithful servant. Thank you so much, and we look forward to all